New subject this week, U.S. Secretary, Interior Secretary, excuse me, Sally Jewell announced that the SunZia Project has the approval it needs to move forward. The planned transmission line would carry energy from renewable sources in New Mexico and Arizona to other states here in the West. Now, supporters of alternative energy say transmission lines are an important component of future development. But Rob, what does this mean for, literally for New Mexico? Does this help our situation about how we move energy back? What do we get out of this?
Well, the proponents say that this could create 6,200 jobs.
Right.
Of course, we've heard those wild sort of estimates before. They haven't quite come true. The interesting thing for me on this was that the Center for Biological Diversity they've come out against it, and most of the green folks have come out in favor of it. So it's not an across-the-board approval.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Rachel, sorry.
I think the supporters see it too as an economic development issue. We have plenty of sun, lots of wind, right. Not so much demand for energy in New Mexico as there is in larger cities. The thought being, if we can get that energy that we can produce here out there, create jobs, create money. It's still got a long way to go.
Yeah, and if California is willing to accept the,
right.
They may not even need it.
Thank you, exactly.
It's very much a strange bedfellows kind of situation, to Rob's point. And we see a project that will economically benefit Steve Pierce's district in the state, and he is one of the loudest opponents of the project. I remember the early discussions of our solar technologies and wind technologies here, and transmission was always the big stumbling block. I think it'll be interesting to see how this plays out.
It's the funnel block, isn't it? We can create all the energy we want, Dan, but if we can't get it out there.
Well, it's the same problem we have with, you know, everybody keeps talking about drill more. I'm not opposed to drilling. We don't have any refinery capacity.
Right.
We're operating at full capacity. So before we go drilling more, we got to build more refineries. Same problem here. Before we put up more wind farms, solar farms, we got to get that stuff out. I think it's a great opportunity for New Mexico. I mean, I just came back from Seattle, where they get 75 days a year of sun, you know, and a lot of those folks up there, I think, would like green energy. They would take that stuff.
You think of Germany.
I think
Germany is like almost completely solar.
Yeah,
and
isn't that amazing?
It's not a very bright sun.
No, I mean, I think
although their costs are going up.
But I think the people got to remember, you know, and I know it's going to be amazing. You think I'm advocating for alternative energy? I'm not opposed to it by any means.
The sky is falling.
I think at the end of the day, though, that there is a market in this country for people that will pay more for that energy. Why shouldn't we be the people that benefit from that, getting the energy out?
Very good point.